Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4. And on this episode, we are going to be doing something we should have done a little while ago, actually, but we kind of got sidetracked with so many things that this game has to offer. But we had this quest to come over here and secure the workshop at the Taffington Boathouse. If you guys remember the episode that we ended that on, there was a radio inside there that needed to be turned off. I went ahead and turned that radio off, and I killed all the enemies inside, as you guys had seen me do already. And now we can actually secure it. So we had already finished the quest. We just didn't finish the quest, which is kind of a shame. But we're going to go ahead and do that. You can now use the workshop at the bluff. Report your success to the people that we were talking to before. And if you guys remember... Actually, I can't do it while I'm in this mode. But you can see where the outline of this shop is. It actually goes all the way out there in the water. So this is going to be a really, really good place to plant a lot of those little water, or not the little ones, but the big ones. Plant the big water things down there. And the reason you want to do that is water is very, very easy to make. Yeah, when you leave and come back, usually you'll have 50 or 60 water just sitting there waiting for you, at least at my base right now. It has something like that. And the cool thing about it is they pay about 11 caps per thing of water, and it's free. It's a renewable resource, so definitely take advantage of it and go and make sure that you have as much of that being created for you as possible in every one of your towns. And that way, you can definitely... we have to head back up here. But yeah, you can make a lot of money that way. And to be honest, guys, you're going to need a fair bit of money in this game because the stuff that I want to do with it especially is... to be able to use my suit. In between when you load, like when you come into the game for the first time, you have these little load screens that kind of pop up, and they give you little information, little pieces of advice. And I went ahead and modded my old weapon as well, so it has a little bit more range to it. It does a little bit more damage as well. As you can see, one shot killed it. That was pretty nice. I like that. Of course, these are easy enemies. They're not like the ones we were fighting a little while ago, but yeah, when you're loading from one place to another, when you're zoning in for the very first time, or you're going through a doorway that leads you through, you know, into another zone or something along those lines, it gives you little tidbits of information. And one of them is that your power suit actually gets a lot of different, like, modifications. You can put, like, a jetpack on it. You can put all these, like, bazookas or Gatling gun things on it and stuff like that. Sounds pretty cool to me. I definitely want to check that aspect of the game out, but... we just can't simply afford to keep buying the power cores that the suit just eats right through. But that's going to change. Like, we're already starting. That's why I put so much effort into my town, because I knew eventually it's going to pay off. And it's actually doing that now. Every time I go back, I have close to about 50 to 80 water, depending how long I've been gone. There's more water there or less water there. And I'll sell all of it, but about 15 of it. And I'll use maybe 5 or 6 of them while I'm gone if I get into a big fight. I usually don't use all that much. And I make a lot of money off of that. Then I also harvest all the resources that my camp is making. And it's making buttloads of melons. It's making a decent amount of gourds. And, of course, what's the other one that is making a lot of? The razor wheat or razor wire stuff, or whatever that case this stuff is. It's making a fair bit of that. And then, of course, it's also making corn and carrots, but it's not making a whole lot of those. So I'm kind of storing those for now. And maybe at some point down the road, I'll have enough stored that I feel comfortable with selling those as well. But between the tattoos, which I usually have like 300 or 400 of those waiting for me, I think you only get 2 or 3 caps for those, to be honest. You don't really get a lot, but it's better than nothing. And then when you throw it in there with... you know, the water that you get, oh my god, you get just so much money. I'm talking about 700 to 800 caps every single time I go back to sell to my vendors. Now, my vendors, they're very low level ones. I weren't able to build the biggest shops yet because we just didn't have the skill to do it. You have to be level 20 before you can put all the points into the stuff that you need to put points into, which is cap collector. And then, of course, 2 points into the town building one, whatever that one was called. I keep forgetting the name of that one. But, yeah, once you do that, you're able to build those, and you'll be able to make a lot more caps off of just the shops alone. Like, the shops are actually earning me money now. When I go back and I check inside my storage thing, there's like 15 or 20 caps, and they're just from the two shops that I've created. More people you have, more money you'll make. The better the shop, the more money they have in there to trade you with, and therefore you're making money, you know, doubly out of that, just because you're able to sell stuff to them, and they have more money as to boot. This is the guy I've been coming back over and over to see, and he's never freaking here. And now that he's here, I don't have anything
to
sell.
Stick to the roads, and you got a better chance of surviving.
Can we trade?
Make a move, and I'll end you.
Well,
wastelander.
I don't think so, but
hey, at least it's honest work.
You can't do nothing to me, man. I'd wipe the floor with you with all my gear and armor. The fact that I can freeze time, I mean, can you do that? I don't think so.
Crop's been growing pretty good lately.
Look at her hair. It's actually wet, guys. That is kind of cool. Yeah, it just surprises me every single time they take the effort to do little small details like that. Why would you take the time to do that? And yet they did it, guys. And I know why they would, because they care. They actually love this game as much as the people who are playing it, so.
I cleared that place out for you. Should be safe for your friends to move in now.
Thanks. Nice to have some good news around here for a change. Hey, by the way, feel free to use our workshop. I'm glad to count you as a friend.
Oh, I am almost to the next level.
I just want to trade a few things.
Okay.
Oh, so they're my guys now. Okay, well, you know what? We're going to take your money. We'll take this stuff as well. You can keep the outfit. I don't really care about that. What about you?
I'd like to trade some items.
Of course.
We'll take your bottle caps. Yeah, we'll take your meat and your razor grain. The reason I take that stuff is because a lot of the time...
Seems to be growing well.
When I come back off camera, I'll give these guys good armor. I'll give them, like, the raider gear. I'll give them middle armor. Whatever I have in storage that I'm not using and that I'm probably not going to use anytime soon, I'll give it to them because... You know, if they're outfitted really well, then they may not die. And that's what I'm really worried about, is these people dying, because I don't know if you get them back when they do die. So I'm very cautious about that. No defenses. This place will definitely get attacked. I just put everything I have away, so there's no way I'll be able to build one of these. Yeah, it just does not have the circuits or the oil. It does have a little bit of steel and gear in there. And, of course, you can always come over here and recycle and take stuff apart. You know, it does come with a little bit of stuff, but... For the most part, you're not going to be able to get too much here, and yeah, you're not going to get the circuits. Those are kind of difficult to find, actually, for the most part, unless you buy them. But yeah, now we got another place, guys. We have another building, another farm area that I can kind of mess around with. I'm actually getting a little overwhelmed as it is with those. I have this one outpost, which, you know, I was kind of doing a little bit off camera as well with that at one point. It's at 54% happiness, and there's 5 people there. I also have my main place, which seems to like it's kind of fixed itself. Not really, because now it's at 14, and I actually have 21 people there right now. So the bed situation is still wacky. I don't know what's wrong with it, but at some point I'm going to build a massive hotel made out of wood that I designed myself, and all it's going to have is beds in it. And if that doesn't solve the situation, I'll just go through and kill every single one of the people in there, because it's really starting to annoy me. I don't know what's wrong with it. It was working fine so well for a long, long time. The Red Rocket truck stop has no people there because I just have not had the resources to build a tower that calls them in, the radio tower. That's the only way that I found to get people in, is to have that radio tower. Wish people would kind of, you know, mosey on in on their own occasionally, but nobody's ever stopped at that place, so that's kind of unfortunate. And then I have the farm area that has 7 people, and that one's doing pretty well. That one, you know, I'm not really too concerned with it. It's kind of like the secondary one right now that I go to, and I go back and forth between the two main places, looting the farm, and I make a fair bit of money that way. And then, of course, I have this one down here, which I haven't also had the resources to build one of those radio towers yet, so nobody's shown up to it. But it has a couple of defense turrets and a farm area and a little bit of water, so it has everything set up. So if people finally show up, they can move in. But yeah, there's so many of them to kind of mess around with that it's really starting to, I don't know. It's kind of difficult, guys. But I think we're going to head over to this because the Bedford Station, what do we have for that one? Talk to the Outline Station, no. Diamond City, is it this one? Let me look at that. Is that why I need to come over here? No, that quest is for this one. So what quest is the Railroad Station? I don't have anything selected, and yet it's still telling me I should go over here. So I guess let's go over there and see what's, you know, kind of going on in that direction. Yeah, in that direction. But yeah, this game is huge, and every single time you come through it, you'll talk to NPCs that are there, and they're like, oh yeah, hey, we're doing this and we're doing that. You come through another time, maybe a day later, maybe you've done something on a different part of the map that seems completely unrelated. And yet when you finally get there, all of a sudden, boom, there's another set of quests for you from those same NPCs you talked to 100 times before. So that's kind of interesting in its own right. I like that. It just makes things very, very difficult to keep up with, because you can't rely on the fact that when you go back to sell, you won't get sidetracked with somebody running up to you and saying, hey, there's something going on, can you please help me, blah blah blah, you know. And then of course you want to help out, you want to, or you don't want to help out, whatever the choice may be, but it kind of distracts you from whatever your main objective was. And I get so distracted in this game so easily because I don't want to forget anything, I don't want to miss anything, and by kind of doing that I miss stuff because I'm so distracted with everything that just kind of pops up in front of me. But I think we've been doing pretty well. It's just it's one of those things, guys. As we go through, we'll have to try to figure stuff out. How do we... can we go up? Is that what it's trying to tell me, to go up? Or is there something else? Is there something else we're missing? Huh. I don't know, actually. I don't know why that that little line is there, unless there's something we're missing over here that... let me look around for a few minutes and see what we can find. If not, I think we're going to go up to that outpost Zuma or Zimana, or however you pronounce the name of that outpost, that you guys really haven't seen all that much of. I'm going to show you some of the stuff we've done to it. Ooh, what is this? Helena's instructions. Oh, yeah.
Pick anything good?
Can't believe it. Every single time they do it, it's like she's completely butt naked. Miscellaneous Helena's instructions. Is this where they do it? I think so. Let's do... yep, there it is right there. So what do we got on this note? The package arrives at midnight. Well, thank you very much for nothing. I think we read the notes before and it said something about a blue crate. Never really found the blue crate. I ran around looking around and never found anything. So if it's here, it's somewhere very difficult to find. Maybe up there or something, because I wasn't able to get up there. But I searched in all these little areas and yeah, never really... what are these? Rataways? Railroad spikes. Oh, yeah, we'll take those. Probably steel on those, glass on these, so we'll use all of that. Again, I have been collecting a lot of resources the last few episodes, and I've been putting them all back into my main house. And the reason I've been doing that is I'm going to be doing a lot of building over there off camera here pretty soon at some point. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff I want to do. I want to expand the shops so that we can start making some serious cash. Why does it sound like somebody's fighting? Over there, maybe? Oh, it does sound like somebody's fighting. Over in that direction, probably. Let me load up my sniper scope and see if we can see what it is. Ooh, what is that? Are those mole rats? Is that what they are? I hate those freaking things. They pop up from underneath you. Can we go into build mode? Yep, they are mole rats. And a settler, so we need to get our butt over there. Rotten landfill. Where are you at, guys? Where are you? There's a settler right there. Ah, oh, come on, come on. Let me get him. Ah, oh, jeez. Come on, get on me, baby. There we go. Where are you at? Let me switch to my gun. Jump back in. You suck, man. Okay, wait for him to pop up. Where are you at? There you are. Yes. I only get one shot with this thing now. It's kind of sucky. You're supposed to get more shots with it when it enters into vats, but I modified it, and I wonder if maybe that ruined it. I don't think it did. I'll have to look at the stats here in a second. Wow. Jeez. You're getting just jumped by massive amounts of these mole rats. Yes, you're gone, buddy boy. Let me look at this real quick. Let me go into my weapon. Hypacity, no, that's not the one. That's the kneecapper. No, that's not the one. It's this one. Improves VATS, hits chance, 25% less action point cost. So yeah, we're getting less action points still on it. It just does more damage. And I guess because of that, is there another one? Where are you at? Let's see if we can get him from way over here. Nope, we missed that guy. Holy crap, man. There is just tons and tons of loot on these guys. Ah, here we go. Oh, two of them? Jeez. Wow, these guys are strong too. Did that settler survive that? I don't think. Oh man. Holy crap. crap. Are these just never ending? Are these just never ending? It seems like they might be. Man, we had pay dirt on this one. I mean, you know, they're not really worth all that much, but the fact that we were able to kill so many of... Dang, dudes. Stop spotting. I don't think this is the way it's supposed to work. Killed that one for me because I'm too slow for loading. Oh, man, another one? There must be a nest or something I need to destroy. Otherwise, these guys just keep popping up over here. But I'm going to keep killing them. I have the ammo for it. That's why I'm using this weapon, because it is a gun that I have plenty of ammo for. Maybe not as much as I have on some of the other guns. I think my 22 has the most ammo. But again, I think that's the Gatling gun one. So I kind of want to save it for that. Where did that girl go? There seems to be a platform up there. We might be able to go up to the top of the bridge. Let's look down here, make sure we didn't miss any loot. What about over here? I think one fell down here. Yeah, there it is. Mole rat teeth. The mole rat teeth, by the way, guys, you can actually use to make little, like, trophies and put them on your house. And, you know, it kind of is actually pretty cool. It shows that you've killed those mobs quite a bit if you got those trophies. Rolled up Boston Bugle. Yeah, that computer's seen better days. I think it's not going to work anymore. Oh, can I knock it down? Look at that. Kick it. Oh, yeah. What if I want to, No, that doesn't seem to want to do anything right there. It does seem like you use AP, though, when you attack with your melee. That's interesting. I never really paid that close attention to it. Melee has not been something I've really used in this game all that much. It's kind of been a, like, last-ditch effort. If I'm getting attacked by a lot of mobs and I don't have time to reload or I'm out of ammo, I tend to use it a little bit here and there. But overall, not that big of a deal. Can I loot the ladder? I love this this one game that I played when I was a kid. It was called Simon the Sorcerer. And in the game, it was making fun of the old adventure games where you picked everything up. Like, just kind of like in this game, where you always picked everything up. And, you know, the joke was, where does it all go? You know, like, how do you pick up the kitchen sink and carry it with you when you're a wizard and all you got is a robe on? And so what they did in that one is when you first started out, there was a ladder that you needed to pick up for something. And so you picked it up, and he opened up his pocket, pulled the ladder, and just kind of dropped it into his pocket. He's making fun of the fact that it doesn't make any sense where all of this stuff is going. And it's true. It's kind of like in this one, where am I holding all this junk? And yet I still complain about not being able to hold enough. So, yeah, it kind of brings me back to that day when I see that stuff. Holy crap. These things are everywhere in here. Oh, more of them. Oh, geez. Oh, geez, dude. Oh, come on, there's still one more in there. I saw him jump in. I think my robot's going to get him. Yep, my robot got him. Thank you. Thank you very much, man. I love you. Rubbish. Don't act like it wasn't that tough. These guys are tough, man. Maybe I should use a melee weapon. Maybe that would be the best bet on these little dudes that were kind of out-leveled and they no longer pose that big of a risk to us. Glow-sided light combat shotgun. I did go back and I also upgraded my shotgun. And I upgraded the one that does the damage to, in fact, I can show you real quick, the one that does the damage to the knees. This is now the kneecapper one. So it does the exact same damage. Actually, it does a little bit more damage than the one we had before. And it does the extra effect of the kneecapper thing. So that's going to be really, really sweet when we start using that again. I've been kind of holding off again because we need to build up our ammo for that weapon again, because we're just not really finding enemies that have shotgun shells for whatever reason. Huh, what is it? Is just that's it? That's all that's down here? Is a mole rat den, huh? I thought maybe something down there, but no, it just looks like that's it. Is there anything here? What is this? Oh yeah, mole rat meat. Plenty of mole rat stuff. So if you're looking for mole rat, this is the place to come. This is the place to get your teeth, your trophy stuff, and a little bit of the meat, so you can make some of those whatever, the popsicles, the meat on a stick kind of thing. Let's see, where were we? That's the light over there, so I think that is where the lift was, and that's where we're going to head. Yeah, that's where... Actually, no, let's go down here to the shop first, make sure we didn't miss anything down here, and then we'll go up there to that. Oh, yeah, we've already searched this. That's right. Okay. I wonder where that chick went. Where did she go? Was it a woman or was it a guy? I wasn't paying too close attention to what that settler was, and I don't even know. I guess he didn't die, because if they had died, their body would be on the ground. Oh, crap. Another radio. Let me see if I can back away and see if I can figure out where that radio... Ooh, what is that? Ooh, it's a rad scorpion. Holy crap. We have not fought any rad scorpions yet, guys. Oh, no. They had to put a rad scorpion in there where a freaking radio was at, didn't they? I'm going to have to sniper this from far away. Nope. We're going to go full bore into this one. Oh, wow. Look, I'm doing very little damage to this thing. These things have a nice protective shell on them. Oh, geez. Reload. Reload already. Come on. Where are you at? There you are. Oh, he has to be in brush. I can't see Jack in there. There we go. We're doing a little bit of damage. One more shot. There we go. Oh, come on. I didn't hit him at all. There we go. Oh, Jesus. Bill Shetler. Provide clean water for sanctuary settlers. So it's telling me that my people back at the base are not happy. Can we kill this guy now? Please. One more shot. One more shot. Nope. He's still a little bit... No, he's dead. I thought he had a little bit of life left on. Don't roll all the way down. There we go. Oh, and you can still hear that music going. Dude. Dinner plate. Why did he eat a dinner plate? He probably ate the person who was having the dinner as well. But they don't show that. And it's kind of funny that my mind kind of ran to that. Is that like four radios? Oh, jeez.
Pick this.
Jeez, what is the deal? This is the programmer's just a sick little dream here. They knew those things weren't going to be allowed on YouTube. And they put three of them? Why would you put three of them? You guys are mean. Very mean. Oh, yes. Jangles the moon monkey. Did we take him? No, we're just moving him around. Actually, let's move him around. Let's get a good view of him. See if the physics in this game are hilarious. Oh, man. There he is right there, guys. That is just one hideous-looking doll right there. Look at the eyes. No kid would want that. And the mouth? Yeah, we'll take it. We'll take it. No idea what those things are for, but they're hilarious. Let's see. Oh, so this guy was probably a scientist. He was studying skulls, or maybe he was into, worshipping the skulls themselves. I think the way it was on the shelf kind of shows that he was some kind of a scientist. Welding goggles? Either he was a scientist and somebody else put this on there, or, yeah, maybe not. No idea. Let's see. Gold-plated flip lighter, duct tape, a ball pin, hammer, and combination wrench. Well, let's see. Can we get in here? He said it's no way he was going
to
get in here, so, yeah, expert lockpick.
This.
Let's look around, see what's in there. You got some blood packs, some rat away, because they knew you were going to get a lot of radiation by coming over here. More rat away. So they locked themselves inside with rat away. Why would they do that? Maybe somebody else locked them in there, but they have plenty of it. Wow, that's a lot of radiation. Let's use some rat away ourselves, because that is that was pretty rough. That might be enough. One. Let's see, how far does it go? One more, probably. Yeah, one more. We'll do one more. And I'll use some water. And the water actually went up all the way. I should have waited again. Let's do one more water. And now our life is full. Okay, I can settle with that. Where was that lift? Wasn't there a lift over here somewhere? It looked like there was. Maybe down that way? Maybe there wasn't. Maybe it just kind of looked like there was. Huh. But I didn't get any updates for any of these areas, right? Well, I did for that one, the rotten landfill. Okay, so let's keep heading over in that direction. Down, I guess. Down in this direction towards Lexington. That will probably lead us to something. It does look like if you follow the power lines or if you follow light, if you kind of look in the direction where it seems like there's buildings, you might find something there. And there is the town out there that we kind of explored a little bit. And then we had to leave because there was just so many people there that we ran out of space. And we never really got back there. Because, as I said, I'm not doing fast travel, guys. I have to run from one location to another. And because I'm doing that, I'm finding a lot of locations that I missed the first time. And it distracts me from getting back to locations that are further away. And that's why we haven't gotten to Diamond City yet. But I'm not really in a big rush to do Diamond City. This game is kind of one of those things where if you do the main missions and you forget the side ones, you don't do the side stuff, you're going to get to a point where you might miss out on some of the stuff that you no longer have access to anymore. Some of the places that you could have gone to will be destroyed, or, you know, because you didn't go there early enough. Because the main mission moves things along. It definitely has its own timetable. And if you use that one and not your own, you know, it's just going to progress the story. But if you run around, yeah, you're using a couple of days here and there, but the game doesn't seem to recognize that as much as it does the checkpoints of the main mission. At least as the way it was in the third one. I mean, I don't know about this one. This one may be a little different from that one. It may actually recognize the fact that you slept 4 days and it took you, you know, 16. Because it kind of did that before where when we went to that traveling bar, you guys actually didn't get to see it. I talked to him off camera. I saved it before I talked to him, and then I reloaded because I wanted to make sure it was something that, you know, was actually a thing and not just, you know, a passing by of, like, scavengers or settlers. But I talked to him, and he had, you know, conversation. There was a voice actor there, and he was a traveling bar, and his people were going with him and stuff. So there was definitely something to be had there. Unfortunately, by the time I made it back to him again, the Sith, the creation, the robots, had killed everybody there. And I managed to kill all of them, of course, but we never got to talk to those people. They're gone now. And that's what I'm talking about is, holy crap, we're already back over here, huh? Well, this is nice. This is something we could definitely look at, but I think I'm going to go back over to the bridge and explore that because that's something we didn't do last time. So much, guys. So big of a game, and I'm just glad that it is, to be honest, because I've been looking forward to this game for a very long time, and I don't want it to be gone that quickly. And I've been playing it like nonstop for the last week and a half, almost to the detriment of a lot of other episodes. So if you're watching and you're like, dude, why did you stop playing the other game? I didn't really stop playing the other game. I've just been obsessed with this one for a little while, and I do apologize. I will definitely get back to those, and I kind of have to force myself to go back and play the other ones, not because I'm not having fun with them, but because I'm having so much fun playing this one. So I do apologize for that, guys. It's unfair to you, especially if you come to expect it to be on and you're like, oh, where's my weekly, you know, whatever episode? It's really unfair in that regard, but it's hard to break away from a game that you're having fun doing, especially since I can sit here for hours and play this game and never even get bored with it. Usually, you know, I had a comment on one of my older videos because, you know, I go back and read all your comments and people were like, oh, one guy actually was just saying, you sound depressed and bored or tired or something like that. I'm like, I wasn't depressed. I was probably tired because I was playing the game for so long, but I don't know when to stop because I'm having fun doing it. Whoa, what is that? What is that? Where does that go? Where is that going? That doesn't point to any of the cities I have on my map. Oh, look at that. That is cool. Jeez, you realize how long it's going to take us to explore this town because I have to search every room of every building? Holy crap, guys. This is massive. And look at the fog. The clouds going through. Some of it's lit up. Some of it's not. Oh, man. Ooh, and there's a monument. There's a boat out there, guys. There's a shipping boat. Oh, the old Taipei sailboats and stuff. Maybe a clipper? I don't know. It's too far away to kind of tell what kind of sailboat it is, but... And what is that? I don't know. Actually, let me switch to this one. This one has a better scope on. No, it's actually pretty close to the same scope. What are those? Satellites, maybe? Hot air balloons? And it looks like satellites. Probably satellites. Ooh, that looks like something. There's going to be something there. There's light. Anytime there's light, it's a good sign. Ooh, what is that? Is that a lighthouse? Holy crap, guys. So much to this game, man. Oh, my God. This is going to take friggin' forever. Forever. Yes, please. Please do. We are not ending this series anytime soon, so... Oh, man, how many episodes do you think we're going to get out of this? Now, I'm trying to do about 30 to 45 minutes episodes because normally 30 minutes is what I try to do because that seems to be the time length that people like. But I've been having some requests to make my videos a little bit longer. Where's that coming from? It sounds like it's coming from really close by. Oh, yeah, right down there. Oh, what is that? It's a scavenger, and we can... Nope, we can't quite hit it, so we're going to go with our sniper and go into that mode. 31%, so better than the, was it 21 or something like that? Oh, nope, not quite. Let's go into stealth, and I'll do it manually. Yes, you're down. What about you guys? Robot? I don't know if you're... I can't go into build mode or into, There you are. What are you doing? Are you coming towards me? Can't quite see you anymore. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? There you are. Okay, you're just gonna stand there. So I can get you right in your... Oh, no! Dang it. I had every chance available and I took too long. There he goes. He's going for it. Let's see if we get him. Oh, yes. Oh, my God. On the move and I still got a headshot. What do you guys think about that one? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I get lucky. Everybody gets lucky. Mr. Gutsy. Well, let's take him out.
Something's afoot.
Something's afoot. What are you, Sherlock Holmes? Something's afoot. Where are they attacking? I can hear the machine gun going off. What are you, Protectron? Maybe I shouldn't attack that guy. He was red, so I assumed he was evil. He was an enemy. But maybe I'll leave him alone and he'll reset. Yeah, because it does look like there's robots in there. A Mr. Gutsy. And I'm hidden again. Okay. Yeah, but I still hear the machine guns going off somewhere over here. This is a nice sniper point, though. I like it. What else can we get? Can we get anybody else? I want to do another shot like that. That was fantastic. That was good for my ego, guys. Because I have absolutely sucked with our sniper so far. Well, maybe not sucked that bad, but not nearly as good as I want it to be. Because you can just fire support. Listen to the military frequency AF95. Okay, let's actually, before we do that, let's save it. Let's save it here, and then I will go into the options, the settings, change my audio for the radio. I hope the music doesn't start playing immediately, because I think I do have it on the radio there. Let's go to radio military frequency. Come on. Where's...
Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Ferrum, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station.
Okay, well, Cambridge Police Station. I guess that's what we're aiming at down there.
Automated message repeating.
Should we go down there, guys? I guess we should. Let's try it. And let me turn that back off. I know it's kind of a pain in the butt for you guys to watch me do that every single time, but I gotta be very, very careful about this stuff. Otherwise, I get those copyright strikes, and then there goes the whole channel. So, yeah, it's a pain. It really is a pain, and I do apologize, but something, unfortunately, we have to deal with. I still hear the gunfire. I still hear that gunfire going off. Now all I need to do is find an easy way down that won't kill me. Holy crap, what is going on over there? Oh, wow. Can we go into... No, we can't go into vats yet. Oh, jeez. Look at that. What is that? Is that a ghoul? I think it's a ghoul, but I don't really want to attack it until I know for sure, because it could be a good guy. Although we have a clean headshot on there. Definitely could take advantage of it. What is that up there on that bridge? It looks like another ghoul. I think they're ghouls. I really do. Feral ghouls right there. But we can't get a shot on them. Let me save it. There's no way we're going to survive this. But just for giggles, let's see. Man, if we had our power suit on, we definitely could. Holy crap, what was that? Did you guys see that? It was like some kind of ghost or something. What was that? I've never seen anything like that before. Oh, man. This is not a good... Let's do it. Let's do it, guys. Oh, this is going to hurt. No! There's no way. I knew we were going to die. But, you know, something about playing, like, the Halo games, you believe you're stronger than you really are. And, no, not on this one. This one, you are just as weak as you think you are in real life. If you don't think you can jump off of that in real life, you shouldn't jump off of it on this one. Now, maybe we might be able to jump off that side. I doubt it, but maybe. This side, for sure not, though, unfortunately. Unless we can find some water. Unless we can find some water back here. Don't think there is any, though. We're going to have to run all the way back. That sucks. There has to be an easier way down, don't there? They wouldn't make you do that, would they? Yeah, they would. Of course they would. They definitely would in this one. Oh, man. I'm going to leave my sniper on just because we are pretty high up here. Is he... That definitely is not the American anthem right there. Signal lost. Should we go all the way back the way we came? Or should we go this way? Oh, you know what? We could jump off over there. Like, if we go back that way, we could jump off onto that bridge and take it down that direction. No, that's a dead end. Though, that does look like water. Radioactive water. Frozen, probably, water, but that might be a method. What about... how do we get to that other bridge, though? Yeah, we might be able to do that. We might be able to jump off one of these. Maybe. I do. If you guys already know, and you're like, dude, it's right over there. I wish I could stream this. Now, I'm actually looking at trying to figure out stream. I did a test video a while back. By the time you watch this one, it's probably going to be a few months old, where you'll see that I tried doing that test video. Didn't really work as well as I wanted it to. Let me save it just in case, because I don't know if I'll make this. Oh, if I jumped, I definitely would have made that, but I didn't jump in time. But yeah, I did a test video for my stream, and if you guys see those notifications pop up, I always label them test when I'm doing it. You don't have to come in. I hate the fact that it sends out the notification. I try to get it where it doesn't send one out when I'm doing a test video. Maybe I'm just doing it wrong and I can actually, you know, do that, but until I figure that point out, unfortunately, it just kind of notifies all the viewers who have subscribed that I'm doing that and I'm live at the moment. I tried figuring it out. It just did not work very well. This is going to kill me. Wow, that did not kill me. That is a little nuts. I thought that would for sure. But we're down. We're finally down, guys. So let's drink some water and get to kicking some butt here. It does look like some bugs are coming for me. That's not acceptable. We got to take these things out. Come on. You can do it. Oh, yeah. Holy crap. I love it when they explode. I absolutely adore that now. At first, I thought it was pretty sickening that they just blew open like that, but now I come to expect it. I come to enjoy watching that happen. Come on. I can't really hit you with this weapon. There we go. Oh, crap. You're legendary. No wonder it didn't do any damage to you. Oh, no. Jump. Oh, I should be using my, my shotgun on you. Why didn't you let me know ahead of time? You're supposed to give me a heads up, man. Oh, if I could hit this guy. Holy crap. We are taking some serious damage. Let me do two more water. Actually, one more. There we go. Let me reload. Where you at? Where you at, little dude? You're still shooting crap at me. Let's get close as possible. 76% chance. Oh, of course you have to reload. Well, at least you can do that in vats. And I'll be able to get a second shot. Oh, wow. Wow. That was a nice... I forgot how powerful this weapon was because we haven't been using it in a while. I love this thing. Why did I ever stop? Punishing Raider chest piece. Let's go ahead and loot that. Reflects 10% of melee damage back on the attacker. You would think it would be covered in spikes for something like that to work, you know? If you're going to reflect the damage or send it back to the attacker, it should look very menacing, but that one doesn't really look that menacing. Six damage, or six defense, and four electrical, and it hasn't even been upgraded yet. Standard, no miscellaneous mods on that yet, so that might be somewhat decent for one of our...
Only work, but wouldn't want to leave the good stuff.
Right? I love how they have, like, these special mobs that are just hidden throughout the game in random locations. Nothing special about this location other than the fact that there is a, you know, police station in this general area, but no guarantee you will ever pass by this area unless, of course, you take the time to go off and explore. See, I'm pretty far away from where the police station is actually at. I have to travel all the way down here. What is that, a construction site? Maybe, yeah, mass gravel and sand. We have a few of these near where I live, and yeah, they have all sorts of, like, different dirts and things of that sort. Military frequency found. Let's keep heading over here. I want to check out that place. Mass gravel. Okay, yeah, we're heading the right way. But yeah, we definitely will have to come back and check out all of this. Oh, man, there's so much stuff over here. This is going to take me forever. Literally, this is going to be like 15, 20 episodes. Holy crap. Really? What did I do to you, man? I mean, yeah, I attacked you earlier, but do you really remember that? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, don't blow up the car and blow me up as well. Dang it. When's the last time I saved? Hopefully the last time I went into my vats. Not vats, into my inventory. I think it saves every single time I do that. I tried to make it where it does that for me, so I shouldn't. It's hiding behind a car is, like, the worst thing you can possibly do. I don't know if it is like that in real life or not, but definitely in the game, hiding behind a car is just suicide. Where is... Where's the bug? Just so I can make sure. Boat fly. Okay, what about the other guy? Actually, let me just go in my inventory and search for the special. Yep, there it is. Okay, so I got it. I just didn't want to leave that one behind. Get all the other stuff and leave that. That would suck. Okay, we're going to try to go back over there. And this time, I'm not going to hide behind a car. Just not going to do it, guys. Shouldn't have done it anyways. I see people in movies hide behind, like, barrels or walls inside of houses. And for people who have never really fired a gun, you may not realize that, you know, bullets go through things. Like, they go through things very easy. And in movies, it's not as realistic as it should be. It's just, it's just there for movies, you know. It's just, they took the easy way out. Are you going to come out, little dude? Come out, little dude. Just move a little bit to the right or the left. Just any direction other than what you're doing is going to work for me. If you don't, I'm going to shoot you right in your eye. Oh, I got you right in your eyeball. There, come on. Come on, dude. Come on, you can do it. Where did you go? Where did you go? There you are. Oh, you need a target. Well, if you came out here, I'd give you a target. Let me back up a little. I am pretty far back, but of course the scope is on, and that's why it looks like I'm close. Yeah, danger. Holy crap. I love the explosions on that. Look at that, guys. Mushroom cloud. You know why it's like that? Because these freaking things have fusion or nuclear reactors inside each one of them. I thought it was like gasoline there for a minute, because that's what we got, you know, obviously, but... This is hilarious that it blows up into like a mushroom cloud every time this happens. We are doing like jack damage to this guy with this weapon. But we're getting there. We're getting there. I have the ammo for it, so I want to use this one. There we go. Wow, that guy was rough. And there's still one more in there. So I think before I get close enough, I'm going to go ahead and put my shotgun on just in case. I don't think the shotgun's really going to do it, though. I think you're going to use a lot more powerful weapons to kill that guy up there. And probably would have been better if I attacked from further away.
Is now a combat zone. You may suffer harm up to and including death if you remain in the area. This notice required by law.
There he is. There he is. I can't deactivate him because I don't have that skill. But we'll go ahead. Holy crap, look at that, guys. Oh, man. With the combination of the two of us, we kicked the crap out of that guy. That was nice. Man, I love my shotgun. I want to use this thing more often. I like trying the other weapons out, but, man, the shotgun is just so fantastic. I say that every single time I get it now, but it really is. I mean, two shots, guys. Two shots compared to what? What, 25 with the other little pistol? But, again, you have to be really close to use this shotgun, so it has its own dangers kind of associated with it. And the ammo, unless you're buying it, may be hard to find. I love the sound. If you sit here and listen, you can hear like the creak and the moan of the girders, the metal kind of warping over the, like, just being old age and blowing through the wind, and it's just moaning and groaning. And the fact that they took the extra time to put that in there, like right there, it sounds like a ghost. It sounds like something very, very cool. Where's my map? Let's go to the map real quick, because there was a quest. Oh, we still didn't get there yet. Okay, so we still need to go down a little further. Okay, I thought we were already there, because we had seen this area up on the top, and I thought that was it, but no, it's still further up here. How far is it? A little bit, actually a little bit, and we're passing by a lot of buildings to get here, and that's unfortunate, because I do want to search all this, but we're kind of running low on time on the episode, and I kind of want to get at least to the entrance. And then on the next episode, we're going to go through that area, because we're not full up on our inventory, so I don't need to run back to town. I can just go straight into that. So we'll just, start another episode right there. Oh, man, look at that. There's another gas station. Is it right there? Yes, it is. It's right over here. All right, guys. Well, I think what we're going to do is go ahead and save the episode here. If you do like these videos, definitely hit that like button, subscribe. It helps the channel grow, and I cannot tell you enough how much I appreciate it, guys. Also, leave those comments down below, because I want to hear what you guys think about this game. Also, did I miss anything? Did you guys find something on the map that I haven't seen? Or did I find something that you hadn't seen because you went there at a different time? I want to hear the different playthroughs that you guys have had. and just some of the cool stuff that may have happened because you did it in a different order. Did you join different sides, different factions? I've heard there's different factions in this game, and you have to choose at some point what faction you want to be a part of. I don't know what the factions are. I don't know which one's the best one to go with yet. If you want to leave those ideas down below, which one you'd like to see me go down the most, I definitely take it into consideration. But I think on this one, this playthrough anyways, because we'll be doing another playthrough of this on hardcore, but on this playthrough, I'll probably go with the one that is the good side, whatever that might be. And there might not even be a good side one to it, but definitely leave those comments, and I will catch you all next time.